Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be what's in my bag and a bag review. Now I haven't done one of these in a while and personally I really like watching them, so I hope you guys do too. The bag that I'm going to be talking about is Linea's new sling bag. So I've been using this for the last couple of weeks. Before I jump into the review, I do just want to give you a little bit of background about Linea in case you aren't familiar with them, because I do have a couple of watches and two bags from the brand already. The thing that I love about the brand the most is that their bags are premium luxury quality but without the premium price point. And personally, I think that you do not need to spend the designer price tag to get a designer quality bag, and Linea is a really great example of that, which is why I think I love their bags so much. And you do get that whole luxury experience when you get the bag too. And I didn't show this when I did my soft tote review, but I want to show you what the packaging looks like because I think it is really premium and you don't often get this with designer bags, especially if you're buying them from a retailer that sells many, many bags. But essentially when you receive your bag, it comes in a beautiful sort of linen box and it's got Linea embossed in gold on the front. And when you open that up, and it's quite a sturdy little box too, it has the dust bag, it's got a little welcome card, and then it has the dust bag in there as well. So I just think that it's a really nice experience to have, especially when you're spending a little bit of money on a bag. Now in terms of the leather that they used for this bag, it's a vegetable tan leather, so it's the same leather as my soft tote. And I do just want to quickly pop them side by side so that you guys can get a little bit of an idea of how it patinas over time, so you can kind of see there's a slight color difference, not overly noticeable. I have had the soft tote for a year and a half now. I went and double checked, maybe a little bit longer, and I did use this every single day for the first 12 months that I had it, so it's definitely been very well loved and seen the light of day a lot. So in terms of the quality of the leather and how it wears really beautifully. It softens up over time. It doesn't really lose its structure though, which I think is great. I've been using this bag for about 2 weeks now, so obviously not as long as my soft tote, but given it's the same leather, I kind of feel like I have a pretty good indicator of how this is going to wear over time, which is lovely. I haven't got a single scratch on it and I have not babied this at all. So I think that's quite good because personally, I don't want to baby a handbag when I've got it. I haven't gotten any scratches or anything like that. Obviously, if you do rub it up against something, you might get a little nick. Usually I find with a grain leather like this, you can smooth it out lightly just using the oils from your fingers. And in terms of the design, you can kind of see it is a teardrop shaped bag. So it has a curvature here and then it's also rounded along the bottom as well. So it's not angular at all. I do really like those kind of soft lines. And then it has this little detail running down the side of the bag. It's almost like black leather piping and it just pops around the bottom of the bag, which I think is really nice. Very subtle design detail that you wouldn't really notice unless you were looking at it up close. It has the adjustable strap, and I am going to show you guys in the cutaway how this looks against my body, both worn at the longest and shortest lengths. I've got it about probably 2/3 of the way up. That's kind of my preferred, just as I want something that sits just in front of, I guess, my belly button. That sort of height is where I prefer it. The hardware on it is gold, which I love because all of my jewelry that I tend to wear day to day is gold, so it works really well for me. And then in terms of the zipper that they use, they've used a YKK zipper, which I think are the best kinds of zippers. They're really, really smooth. They don't drag when you open them. It's just a really nice kind of open shut closure. So that is kind of a little bit about the detail of the bag. Inside is cotton canvas line, just like the soft tote. So I do think that that kind of adds to the quality of it, which is really nice. And it has two interior pockets, so that's quite good because I think it helps when you're compartmentalizing all of your items to be able to find everything really effortlessly, which is something I personally like. So I tend to keep my card holder in one side, which is the one that I use every single day. It's got my Opal card in, it's got my bank card in, it just makes things really simple. On the other side, I like to keep things like lip glosses or my car key. And it doesn't have any branding, so I really love that about Linea bags. They're very, very subtle in terms of their branding. There's just a little leather patch on the interior of one of the pockets. So it makes it very sleek, very simple. You wouldn't really know where it was from unless you knew, and you know, when you know, you know. That's kind of my preference when it comes to bags, and it's really a reason why I haven't bought into so many designer bags, because I'm not an overly flashy person. So yeah, that is sort of the detail of the bag, and as you can see, it is pretty full. I've been using this at the moment as my daily go-to bag, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a bird's eye view and show you everything that fits inside. In terms of what I've got in here, I have got my two card holders. These are the ones that I have been using for years, and I really like them because they're very slim and streamlined and they fit into smaller bags. I've got my key case. This one's from Louis Vuitton and I like it because it does protect the interior of my bags from my keys. I have a couple of packets of mints. I personally really love Fisherman's Friends. I think they are the best. I have my cell phone in here. This is an iPhone 8 Plus. My vlogging camera in here. I like to just carry this camera around with me in case I just want to take some photos on the go. I also have a pair of sunglasses. Then in one of the pockets, I do have my car key, which I've got separate from my house keys, and I have a lipstick and a lip balm. So as you can see, just from the top profile, there is still a bit of space in there, despite the fact that I've got all of my essentials. So I could probably pop my passport in there if I was traveling. I could also fit maybe a couple of makeup compacts as well. And it zips up really nicely. There's no bulging or anything like that. So yeah, it's a really great day-to-day size for me, especially now that I'm working from home and I don't have to take my lunch with me to the office. And I quite like the fact that this can really work for both evening out, I think, especially if you go for the black option, because that's a little bit dressier. And for me, it really works because I can wear it either on my shoulder, which I think is the dressier option, or across my body if I want to be completely hands-free and not worrying about where my handbag is. While I don't always look for this in a bag, just because I've never had to worry about pickpockets, I really like the fact that it does have that zip-up closure, because it means that all of your items are really secure and you don't have to worry about any sticky fingers trying to pull things out of your handbag. You're definitely going to notice if they are. And I think that the size works really well against my frame. So I'm 5'8" for reference, and I will show you in a couple of cutaways how this looks against my body. So that is Linya's sling bag. I will drop down in the description box below links to everything that I featured in this video. So everything inside my bag, plus where you can go and pick this up or find out a little bit more information if you are interested in it. A huge thank you to Linya for sending me this bag to road test ahead of launch. I've really been enjoying using it, and as I said, it's kind of become my daily go-to bag just because it fits all of the essentials. There isn't really much more that I need to take with me at all. So yeah, that was my review and what's in my bag. I'd love to know what you guys think of this one, and as always, don't forget to hit the thumbs up if you did enjoy it, and subscribe if you're new and you want to see more videos from me. I definitely want to do more bag reviews and things like that in the future, so keep your eyes peeled for those, and I'll see you guys next time with a brand new video. See you soon. Bye.